This video will be useful for those who are appearing NEET exam. Today's topic is reproduction in organism. Reproduction is the fundamental feature of all living organisms. It is a biological process by which organisms produces their young ones. Reproduction is of two types: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction done by single parent without the involvement of gamete formation. Sexual reproduction done by male gamete and female gamete. First topic we are going to learn about asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is common in the member of phylum Protista, bacteria and archaea. In asexual reproduction, the offspring shows uniparental inheritance, which means offsprings are showing the parental characters. Fission is the division of parent body into two or more identical daughter individuals. There are four types of fission: binary fission, multiple fission, sporulation and strobilation. In binary fission, the division of nucleus is called karyokinesis and the division of cytoplasm is called cytokinesis. In the case of paramecium, there are two nucleus, macronucleus and micronucleus. Macronucleus divides by A mitosis and micronucleus divides by mitosis. Euglena reproduce by longitudinal binary fission. In case of multiple fission, it produces four or many daughter individuals by equal cell divisions, and the young one does not separate until the process is complete. This division is called repeated fission. Example, Verticillia. In Plasmodium, if multiple fission occurs in zygote, the process is called zygogeny and the daughter individual are called merozoite. When multiple fission occurs in oocyte, it is called sporogony and the daughter individual are called sporozoite. Amoeba withdraws its pseudopodium and secretes the three-layered protective chitinous cyst wall around it and it becomes inactive. This phenomenon is called encystment. Pseudopodiospore or amoebulae are produced from the encysted amoeba. Plasmotomy is the division of multinucleated parent into multinucleated daughter individual with the division of nuclei. Next one is about budding. When buds are formed on the outer surface of the parent body, it is known as exogenous budding. Example, Hydra. In Hydra, budding is initiated by pushing of ectoderm and endoderm. In Nacticula, hundreds of buds are formed inside the cytoplasm and many remain within the body of parent. This is called endogenous budding. In Spongus, mode of asexual reproduction occurs by internal buds called gametes. Next one is about the fragmentation. Fragmentation or pedal lacration occurs in many genera of sea anemone. Fragmentation in Tenia solium, the gravid ripened proglottid or the oldest at the posterior end of strobila. The gravid proglottids regularly cut off either singly or in groups by the process called apolysis. Next, regeneration. Regeneration was first studied in Hydra by Abraham Tremblay in the year of 1740. Regeneration is of two types, morphallaxis and epimorphosis. In morphallaxis, the whole body grows from a small fragment. Example, Hydra and Planarian. In Planarian worm, if it is cut into two or three pieces, each fragment can be grown into entire planaria. In epimorphous is replacement of lost body part. There are two types, reparative and restorative. In reparative, regeneration done in damaged tissue, that is healing of wounds. In restorative, body part can be developed. Example, starfish and tail of wall lizard. To learn about sexual reproduction, watch our next video. Share this video with your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.